getting it. I replaced my Orca, which was a very large ship, which I did passenger runs with it. And doing those runs, I made a lot of credits and whatnot and invested about 54 million credits into my Orca. And now I am picked up the Krait Mk II in the hopes of doing some multi-mission, mainly to rank up my federal rank as well as doing passenger missions as well. So I got the ship at the Jameson Station. I don't think that's the name. large CCD lasers on the top. two 2F multi-cannon mediums on the bottom. As you can see, I have quite a good amount of total power in terms of deployed and retracted, so I'm not really close to that max. For the utility mounts, I have not installed anything. I plan on either doing shield boosters and kill warrant scanners, or chaff launchers, or ECMs. I like ECMs sometimes, because ECMs you have the ability to at will charge it up, but then you're screwed if someone fires off a missile or something in the time period while you're waiting for it to cool down. Wow, the stock here changed from the station. So I have a 17 power plant, 60 thrusters, 5A frameshift drive, which is the largest you can put on this ship, 7A power coupler, 60 sensors, and of course, fuel tank. And then of course, I have 60 shield generator, 60 business class passenger, 5D fighter hangar, fighter bay, fuel scoop, business class, advanced discovery scanner, planetary vehicle, SRV to do scouting around and stuff so I can do the engineering stuff, which I haven't done yet. Standard docking computer. I like the docking computer in the sense that it gives you that ability to get up and walk away and use the restroom, grab a drink, or whatever, while you're landing the craft. Now, bear in mind, if you have a passenger who is wanted on your ship and is considered an illegal passenger, you are more than likely going to rig for silent running and go for the mail slot, so that way you don't get scanned. The same thing goes for if you pick up a passenger who is paranoid and does not want the ship to be scanned. And that's about it. I mean, I have some stored modules from when I was using my Orca, just in case I decide to re-get my Orca. Let's go back to Jameson, because I am allied there.
Using lethal force.
You get to hear the engine sounds, etc.
Docking clamps retracted. You are go for departure.
Just make sure of something here.
Frameshift drive charging.
That'd probably be a little better. I don't know why. that same? I already looked at that one. I always leave it on this first one, just in case the pirate NPC decides it wants to pull me out of Super Boots. Showcase some of the things that I like in a game, etc. You may not like, but that's what leaving comments and stuff is fine. I am, even though I have a huge game collection, I am very casual. So, because I am very casual, I don't really have the ranks that I would really like to have. So. So we go ahead here. Jameson Memorial. Which requires you to have. Requires you to have the Founder's World permit in order to come to the system. But Jameson Memorial is a cool place because it's a station that sells every single ship that's in the game. And I think that's pretty damn awesome. Showcase the auto dock if you haven't seen it before. It's pretty interesting because it plays like music that's back from the 80s. Here's the music. Sorry about that. I wanted to make sure that the game was not louder than I was speaking. for missions. That's not bad. Oh, you're far. Ah, let's go pick this one. That's not bad. 12 business people. Wow, 6 million. Oh, that's not bad. Yeah, not bad at all. What about this one? I'd have to come back and do this. Let's try a mission. That way you folks can see it in combat, because who the heck wants to watch the Krait Mk II do a passenger run? All right, folks, here we go.
Detachment complete. You are go for departure.
Looks really nice, doesn't it? In space. But see, now you can understand why it looks... It's like, hey, why did we do this? Why did we put the top on the bottom and the bottom on the top? Interesting, right? It does look, though, like a viper met a cobra. In my opinion. Kill the person that I get the... I mean, I got a bounty, but I have to figure out where the hell to turn it in. I thought with the recent update I could turn it in wherever, but I guess I misread it. I should be Scandinavia. It says scan the nav beacon, so do that. Away my stuff. Whoa! There we go.
Frameshift drive charging. Ready to engage. 4, 3, 2,
let's try and find our target.
Engage.
Maybe I'll be lucky and I won't have to pull my rabbit out of my hat because I did one of these missions before and it was totally easy to do. Thank you. his child. Well, that's a federal security force. Definitely not trying to go for that. Hey, there he is. All right. Submitting. Here we go, guys.
Fighter successfully deployed,
That
is
that simple, folks. Now, if only the Python had that.
Fighter is docked successfully. Keep moving away, Commander.
That was beautiful, wasn't it?
Scan detected.
Yeah. I guess we'll head to Meredith City.
Frameshift drive charging. Ready to engage.
Go claim that bounty.
Engage.
Oh, it's nothing to that. I like that. And my Viper, it's kind of a pain. Obviously the Orca I would never fight with it because it's just not designed to do it. I owned the Viper Mark IV and thought that was okay. I owned a Cobra for just a little bit. I just didn't like it. I did try the Python, I tried the Asp Explorer, because I was going to do exploring, and just didn't like that. I tried the Diamondback, and I didn't have the money to actually get it to do the huge jump ranges. I did get the Python at one point, but I just didn't like the way it moved. And bear in mind, you know, I know with engineering and things like that, you can really take care of the issues with that, but since I'm a casual player, I haven't really dived into the engineering aspect of the game as much as in theory I should have, and therefore I just haven't gotten into that. I mean, you can just tell by my status, you know. I got a lot of ways to go here.
Authorization to be inside the docking bay? Remember, loitering is a violation.
Sure it is. All right.
Blocking bay access is a crime. Don't risk annihilation. Make way for other vessels.
I think I can. Nope. There we go.
Sanctioned acts of aggression will not be tolerated. Obey station law
and enjoy your voyage.
And launch. Spin.
Disengaged. Observe station regulations on exit.
Observe minimum clearance distance.
Landing gear retracted.
Sounds like one of the Transformers. That was a Type 10 Defender right over my head. look at your ship in hyperdrive, but I totally know why you didn't, because you didn't get back in your ship in time. Well, let's just say you don't want to end up a burning hostile sun. Yeah, I found a video once on YouTube a while back. It says just about when you get to about 8 seconds or whatever that number means in terms of time to drop your throttle down to 75% or 25% in that blue area, and you will never overshoot your target. So it's a great thing to know, because I hate doing the whole, oh crap, I missed, I gotta turn around now. All right. I'll rank up again. That'd be nice. I ranked up yesterday. I don't know what follow-on missions mean. I like donating. Mm-hmm. 82%. Okay. All right. Let's do a passenger one. No, I can't do that. That's 20,000 light years. I'll be on this for hours and hours and hours. And I probably cry. Ah, here we go. Perfect. That one's simple. So these type of passenger missions are like courier missions. You just pick up your passengers, drop them off, and continue on your way. The VIP missions are the ones that you
disengage your landing pad, moderate speed on exit.
And
landing gear retracted.
And at the same time, they're lucrative. The difference is you go on a very, basically a long cruise with your passenger, and you take them to where they need to be, and then you come back to the station where you received the mission in the first place to take them. So we're just running silent. Watch.
Thermal signature restored.
Yeah, I looked at getting the shield a little bit better so that way it charges up faster. Gives you a good idea of how well the shield is. Still haven't gotten into the whole shield boosters and they're not shield batteries. They're, I guess, disposable things that keep the shields going. Whoops. That's disheartening. My controller's being weird. Landing on a planet. Oh yeah, that's better.
Incoming mission critical message.
Oh boy. What? Are you under attack?
flight engaged.
Kids, don't try this at home. I did that myself. Oh well.
Frameshift drive charging.
Here we go. Ooh, it cruises pretty well. If this one plays music or not. Oh, it is.
Landing gear deployed.
Nope, wrong one. And we will do this. See, this guy's a criminal. I always get kind of leery about picking those guys up. It's like, do I really want to do that? Oh, damn. Wish I could sell more stuff to you. All right, folks. I think that's it for me tonight. So, if you like this video, I just say like and subscribe. Put some comments down on what you think I should do next. I'd appreciate it. I'd also appreciate if you like, subscribe, and share these videos. And check out my channel to see the other Let's Plays I've done. Other than that, thank you, and have a good night. And I may see you in the black.